some various representatives going to be in our play, our singers, our cantata, and the story of Christ and the story of humanity will be revealed tonight in all as well. If you've never been here before, you should need the facilities. Out this door up to the ramp, the right is the men's, and over to the left is the ladies. I would ask you please to check on your cell phones to make sure that they're not on, and it's easy for that to happen. And at this time, we'd like to go to prayer. We want to remember all those prayer requests this morning that was mentioned. We want to remember those that have grieved or lost their loved one, the Janet McFall family, that go tomorrow for the funeral. Also, we want to remember the Newtown, Connecticut tragedy and all the funerals they have to go through the next day or so. And if you need a prayer request, anybody up there, amen. God, will you bow with us in prayer? Almighty God, as we come here tonight, we thank you for allowing us to come to your house of prayer. Thank you, Lord, for gathering us together as families. We have parents, grandparents, great-grandparents. We have aunts, uncles, friends, and neighbors here. Tonight, on behalf of these choir members and these children in play, we pray a blessing upon this tonight. And for the Sister Tina has written and so well expressed what's really going on in society today. I hope everybody will listen to what is being said. Father, we pray for these that breathe over lost their loved ones, particularly those there at the school event up in Connecticut. And God, I just pray that you would bless them, help them, Lord, as they have to go to that graveside there for day tomorrow and day coming. God, we pray for the McFall family as they also have to go to the graveside tomorrow. God, just bless us now as we all examine our hearts and realize that the true gift is you, God, giving us Jesus as our personal Savior. What a great giver you are, God. Thank you for what you're doing. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Turn the service over.
shine on brightly decorated hearths. Families are gathered around the evergreens, exchanging gifts, and the glorious fragrance of Christmas cooking mixes with the sounds of Christmas carols to create the perfect holiday scene. Peace seems to dwell here, and hope, and even joy. But in many homes, the Christmas scene is far from perfect. The gifts are scarce, the family is distant, and there is loneliness.
Ties all the bows. It's not the first time she's done Christmas Eve alone. Well, it's been 3 years since he's been gone. But when she sees her baby smile, she finds the strength to carry on. Cause hope has found a way tonight to make her heart its home. She believes in Christmas, and she's not the only one who keeps on wishing for that peace on earth to come. So hold her close and let her know your love will see her through. For she
Savior. Those who heard the good news believed and received Jesus as their Savior. Immediately, they went out to share the good news of the Christ child.
Well, maybe later this evening. Hey, why don't we invite
From hearts that are at peace with God, hope can spring up. It is certain that what God has done in the past, He will continue to do forever.
God, I know You are in control of every circumstance. Lord, I trust You with these bills, our home, and my family. No matter what, I know You are in control and will continue to take care of us. Amen.
Thank you.
does your hope come from? Jobs, possessions, friends, family? If those are your only source of hope, you will be surprised how temporary those things can be. Jobs and possessions can be lost in an instant. Friends, even family, can fade away over time. The sure foundation, our true home, is in God the Father, and by trusting in Christ, His Son, we can know that all things work together for our good. God is our hope.
Well, because our hope is in you. Amen.
beautiful.
Thank you. And you know, Madison really enjoys having Anthony as a neighbor.
Mr. Williams, I would really like for you to stay with her.
Well, we would too, Madison, but if I don't find a job soon, we're going to have to move out.
What kind of work do you do, Mr. Williams?
Well, I have been an accountant for many years, but the company I worked for closed down back in the summer. And I haven't been able to find work ever since. Thank you so much. That'll be a godsend.
Thank you so much. That would be such a blessing.
You know, I think we should take a moment right now and just thank God for the blessings that He has given us. You know, it just seems like He's brought us together. He sent you as a gift to our family, and hopefully you're considered a gift to your family. You know, I recall in the Bible where He just said that God will all things together for the good of you. Let's pray. Dear God, we do thank you.
something that everyone longs for, joy. True joy, the kind of joy that only God can give, pure joy. It is our prayer that no matter the circumstance you face, that you find the unspeakable joy that is only found in Jesus.
Come on back up, Cass. All of you. Wow.